What's up, traders, and welcome to another section of the Greatness Forest Academy. Now, in this video, we are going to talk about Confluence 101.4. In our former videos of Confluence, we stopped at Confluence 101.3, and we have not been adding one factor to our Confluence, which is the fundamental factor. But starting from this video, Confluence 101.4, all other factors will be added. Okay, so without wasting much of your time, let's get straight into the video and see what we've got. Now, if you all notice, okay, the students should know we are in this trade already. We are running risk-free already in this trade. We took this trade since Monday, and we are running risk-free already for a 1 to 3 risks to reward. Now, I'm deleting these tools because I want to add other conferences, and I'll be explaining just the USDCHF only. Other the same thing I'm going to explain for USDCHF apply to all other pairs that are here, but I'm going to try my best to glance through all other pairs that are here so you understand the factor very well. Now, in our previous video of confluences, I told you get confluence from multi-time frame analysis, confluence from structure, confluence from tools, and confluence from the fundamentals, which are the COT, or say the hedge funds. So we are going to start. I won't go back to explain that. You can visit my previous videos. So I'm going to start now by analyzing technically with all the conferences before we go back to the fundamental. Now, as you can see, these are the pairs we have in our watch list for this week, and I think I'm running risk-free already in this first two, USDCHF and CAT-CHF. Now, what am I going to do? Let's start with the weekly time frame. Let's start with multi-time frame analysis conference. Now, remember I told you that if you've watched my previous video, that you visit the monthly time frame once in a month because it's one candle per month, and you check the close of the former candle every week. You visit the weekly time frame once in a week because it's one candle per week, and you visit the daily time frame every day, and you visit the 4 hour time frame every 4 hours, and the 1 hour time frame every 1 hour to see. Depends on how, or it all depends on the type of trader you are. Now, technically, you can see this is a bearish move. The market is currently in a downtrend without having to zoom off. You can see it's currently in downtrend because it has broken structures. Now, what can you see here? Now, what are we doing? We just pick the first tool. This is the first tool we're making use of. Remember, all these are we're explaining my conference 101 video. Now, what am I expecting? This is an M formation. I'm expecting a push to this area to form a double bottom, and there should be a retracement to this neckline, which will be a buy trade few weeks from now. But currently, market is in a downtrend coming to retest this area. But before you get to this area, we need to look for a way to follow this move from lower time frame. So overall, this is the area that we are supposed to make our entry, but we have missed it. So which area should we make entry again? This is another structure area. As you can see from here, this is a structure area. We can also make entry here. But how do we do that when we are on the in the weekly time frame? We'll go back to the daily time frame and see what the market is showing from this region. Okay, now as you can see, I can draw a trend line here to get more confluence, because these are this technical analysis, and we'll get confluence from tools. Now, first, from this trend line, if I was to make my entry here, though we traded this, let me check, we traded this last week for a 1 to 4 risk to reward from the 4 hour time frame. Let me check if this was the area we traded it. I just want to show you something. Nothing, no big deal there, no big deal. Okay, from the 4 hour time frame, yeah, I'm correct. This was the area we took a sell to this area for a 1 to 4 risk to reward, and right now we are currently on a sell also for a 1 to 3 risk to reward, and we are risk free already. So going back to the daily time frame, Okay, on the daily time frame, you can see. Okay, let me quickly explain something here. On the daily time frame, this was the area we traded last week, and this week you can see this was the area we identified from the weekly time frame that the market has passed this region. We can't take entry there again, and this is the area we identified from the weekly time frame also that we can take our entry. And truly, this was where we took our entry when our rules were certified on the 4 hour. This was our where we took our entry. And our take profit was somewhere here. Yeah, stop loss was here for a 1-3 risk to reward, and this was the area our take profit was, and this was the area our stop loss was. And we are getting a 1-3.7 risk to reward, which is a good risk to reward, and we are running risk free already in the trade because the market has created so many structures before now. So let me delete this off. Now this was the area we identified from the weekly time frame that will take our entry. So going on the 4 hour time frame, there are other factors we looked out for before we were able to take this entry, and we didn't look out for this factor just by looking at the technical aspect but also from the fundamental aspect, because they added more shots here. I will explain that when we get there. So technically, overall, we are looking for a short, and it's to this region. Now for you to use the fundamental or COT, you must be very good technically. Why did I say so? Technical analysis works with the fundamental analysis, so you can't just be looking for the COT or how to identify from the hedge funds without you knowing how to identify the technical analysis structures region, or how to analyze technically. Let me put it that way. Okay, technically we are looking for a short, and we have gotten our region. We are going to be looking for our entry. Everything is set technically. Which other factor do we have remaining? Now we have used the multi-time frame analysis factor for the confluence. We have used the tools. We have used structure, and there's one more tool we haven't used, which is this. And I will be looking out to the golden ratio. Okay, good. This is the golden ratio. This red line here. And as you can see, that's the area that rejected the market, which is the Fibonacci retracement tool. Now, which other thing do we need? We need confluence from the hedge funds, confluence from COT. Now, how do you read COT? That is for the student alone. But let me quickly do my best now, because I wouldn't want to teach how to read COT data here. How to extract COT data, how to read it, how to set up, how to do all that is for the student only. So let's go over to our website. From our website, you can see the first pair here is the USD. So let's check out for USD. Okay, last week USD has 20k long, 16k short. They closed, sorry, they added 2k short, they added 6k longs, and overall 61.5% longs and 47.7% short and 4k net positions. Overall, last week USD was bullish, and this week you can see they closed 10k short. So we have position open 10k, 16k position open for shorts, longs 10k, shorts 16k. What happened? You see the difference here. They close just 47 shorts and 10k longs. Overall, we have 54.3% longs, 81.2% short, and the net position was minus 5k. Overall, USD is bearish this week. Last week it was bullish, this week it was bearish. Okay. Now let's go for you CHF. USD is bearish this week, and let's see if CHF. Now what we are to be looking for, we should, before we can take this shot, CHF must be bullish. Yeah, because if not, we can't take this shot. Since USD is bearish, for us to take this shot, CHF must be bullish. Okay, this is the CHF. Okay, last week CHF had 10k longs, 8k shorts. They closed 2k longs and they added 4k shorts. Overall, last week we have 25.2% longs, 20.9% short, and 1k net position. This week we have 9k longs, 7k shorts. They close 1k longs and they close 1k shorts. Overall, we have 55.6% long and 21.1% short, then 1k net position. Like I said, as you can see, CHF is bullish because the longs are more than the short. Look at the open longs, open shorts, look at the percentage long for long, percentage for short. So overall CHF is bullish, and USD is bearish. Like I said, we can't take this trade until CHF is bullish. So since CHF is bullish and USD is bearish, you can see we're already in this trade. There's the reason for our entry. The fundamental must be in confluence with the technical. Now, after getting this, we don't even need to go to any news website like the ferrisfactoryinvesting.com. This already gave us all we want, and we're in this trade running risk free already for a 1 to 2 weeks to reward. And I mean, we're already getting a 1 to 2 weeks to reward, but the overall target is a 1 to 3 weeks to reward. So as you can see, we've gotten all factors. We've got multi time frame analysis confluence, we got the structure confluence, we got the tools confluence, which are all these, and we also got what, the fundamental confluence. So these are all factors that we're adding. So trading is not about knowing where knowing the direction of the market or know where the market is moving to. Trading is about you knowing your entry and also having other factors backing you up before you take your entry, because all strategies on earth give direction of the market. They tell you where the market is heading to, but not all strategy give you your exact entry, and not all strategies give you these factors. Let me put it that way. I'm trying my best not to talk about some things here. That is why you see me trying to, you know, talk very slow. There are some things that are not supposed to be said here because they are a bit more advanced. So for the AUD/NZD, technically we wanted to short this pair at this region, but as you can see, the region has been broken to the upside, and this pair, we're no longer looking for a short opportunity, so we can remove it from our watch list. But let me leave it because of weekly forex focus, so I can explain why I removed it from our watch list. So we won't be looking at COT for this because it already disobeyed our setup. Technically, the setup has failed. But overall, with what I'm seeing, it might still go down because this is trying to form a head and shoulder pattern. So we'll be looking at it till Friday. Let's see if we can see a trading opportunity. Remember, before you try to trade, before you go over to the COT, you must be good technically, and your technical analysis, you must have a definite direction and entry before you check the COT. And for CHF, we're already running risk free already. Yeah, we're running risk free already for this. And as you already know, CHF is bullish. Now let's quickly check for CAD. CAD must be bearish. Yeah, it should. If it's not bearish, then the student should understand where we said that also. Like I said, CAD is bearish. Look at it. Last week we had 22k longs, 47k short. They added 2k longs, they closed 5k shorts, 18.5% longs, 39.1% shorts. Overall, it was a negative 24k longs for last week. This week we have 19k longs, 45k short. They close 2k longs from the 90k longs, and they close 1k longs from the 45k shorts. They close 1k shorts from the 55k shorts. And overall, we have 15.7% longs and 36% short with a negative 25k net positions. So overall, CAD is what? Bearish. And what? CHF is bullish. So like I said, for us to take this trade, CHF must be bullish and CAD must be bearish, and we are running risk free already, and this for a 1 to 10 risk to reward. So we are running risk free already in this trade. For Euro card, no definite entry yet, so no need checking the COT. Technically, we don't have a definite entry, we don't have a defined entry. This trend line wanted it to break and retest before we take our entry, and it has broken and retested it. But we notice there is another trend line from the upside which can push this market to the downside. So we might be looking out for a double bottom or something else. But once we've gotten a definite entry or a definite signal, that we can go over to confirm from COT, and if the COT are engaged our technical analysis, then is either we take the risk with 0.5% risk instead of 1%, or we don't take the risk at all. Because if you are trading against the banks, then you are your stop loss, sorry, your take profit is going to battle with them. You are taking too much risk. So this is all for now. I believe you understand, the concept is clear. So do not forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel and share to your friends and family who want free forex education. This is all for now. You can send questions to us and join our community on YouTube, on Facebook and Telegram. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching.